Hi everyone, I'm Giancarlo.
And I'm Felicia.
And this is our preview video of Gamboni.
Me, bro, Gamboni.
Hey, yo!
Gamboni is a mafia territory control game where players fight to be king of New York. Let's jump right in and look at the setup. Place the playing board, which represents New York, in the middle of the table. Each will receive one boss card with the color face up, one skill chip of that family color, two weapon cards, $5,000, and a stack of territory markers of their color. Place the boss, cards, and family chips at the safe house. Place two family chips for strike, one and two for each family. Place $10,000 in the gang cash pool. Once set up, you're ready to vie for control of New York City.
Before we begin, I just want to point out that each family has their own special abilities. The board will have a victory point tracker for each family and score points depending on actions you do. Depending on the number of players, you'll play a certain number of rounds. Now let's take a look at what you can do on your turn. First, you collect your money from controlled areas. You'll get $2,000 per area. For each area you control, you will put two chips on the power line. When you lose control of the area, you'll remove two power chips. Then you collect money from your business, which can only be placed on green sites or your safe house. These businesses range from low risk to high risk. You can also protect your business by adding one weapon card face down under it in case it gets attacked. Once you collected the money, you can do the move action.
When you take the move action, you can move your pawn 5 spaces without diagonals. For every location you visited which was empty, you place a family token there to show you now control it. When you land on a spot controlled by another player, you are attacking them. The attacker plays a face down card, then the defender. Reveal the card and the highest player wins. Attacker wins ties. The defender can also choose to simply walk away and not play a card. If ever you land on another player's boss pawn, a boss fight occurs. During this fight, a couple things can happen. If the attacker wins the fight, he takes all of the other player's money. The losing player also loses one life point and one respect point. However, if you attack and lose, you go to jail and your turn ends. The defender also gains one respect for having defended himself. If you go to jail, your bailout is $5,000 times the number of respect you have.
When moving, if you pass on the commission icon, you get to draw a card from the C deck. There are two types of cards, read out loud and secret assignments. These will offer rewards when done. Now, if you're ever running low on cash or morale, you can always go to the FBI to snitch and make some money. However, a rat always has a price on his head, and if a player attacks and wins a fight against a snitch, they get the reward money. When you do visit the FBI, you also get a card and read it out loud. If you ever are in battle, you can hire gangs instead of getting your hands dirty. You can reveal up to 3 cards on top of the weapon deck to make the attack, but it costs $5,000 for each card you show. But at least this way, if you lose, you won't go to jail. The money used will go to the gang stash. If you want, you can always attack the gang, and if you win, you take the entire stash. If you lose a fight while defending, you'll be sent to the hospital.
After moving, attacking, and snitching, you get to buy up to 3 cards. You can buy from the weapon deck or the business deck. Once you bought cards, you do the final action of your turn, which is to deposit money. For every $25,000, place a chip on the money track. Now let's talk about a few other rules. On the board, there are limos you can use to fast travel to other areas. You can always make alliances with other bosses. This is called kissing the pinky ring. If you do, both bosses lose respect points and are now working as a team. Be careful though, when you offer to kiss the pinky and the other player refuses, then it's a vendetta. You can only attack that player for the rest of the game. Keep playing the game until the round marker reaches the end and the player with the most points is the capo of New York City. We hope you enjoyed our preview video of Gamboni. Keep in mind that this is a prototype and the components will be much better in the final version. If this seems like something that you and your group would enjoy, check out the Kickstarter and back it.
Ooh. Me, I'm a star internationally all over the world. That's what Italians do. We
exaggerate.
We and we repeat things twice, but like differently. Me, I am a star internationally,
big time,
all over the world,
all over the
internationally
world.
All over the world, me, I.
So I work in a club.
Okay.
And last week, these kids, I agree, they were buying a lot of
when I say kids, I mean like 19-year-olds, were buying a lot of, they were buying a
which
lot of
which is legal in Montreal.
It is 18.
In the States,
yes,
it's
in
like
the States.
21. Okay, go on.
And in Europe, it's like 12. so it's true. At 14 years old, I was buying cigarettes in Europe. Yeah, so I agree. They were buying 20 shots each. Yes. So then at the end of the night, he sees me. I went to the bathroom. He was getting his coat at the coat check. And he's like, hey, it's the girl. She was shaving us all our shots. I bought all kinds of drinks off for you. I'm sure you never saw ballers like this before. Right? No, never have I ever seen a baller like you before.
Mr. Gamboni.
Mr. Gamboni.
That's funny.
Yeah.
Did they try and mack you?
They try sometimes.
They try?
But like, I have a bitch face, so...
I mean, yeah, but sometimes it turns guys on.
I know that.
Yeah. Like that.
The meaner I am.
Like to me, it's like, oh, challenge accepted.
A guy actually, he looked like a last week, but he kept buying drinks off of me. It was really nice. And then all of a sudden, he's like, you know, you're really beautiful. I was like, wow. Never judge a book by
See,
face.
Women. The guy looks like, and they end up with, wow, he was really nice. Moral of the story is, nice guys finish last.